Good evening. If you want to have a breadboard friendly and a user-friendly ESP8266 module, you have to do it yourself. In this video, we make one.
ESP8266 microcontroller is this chip here with a ground plate in the middle and 32 little pads around it. The other components we need today are a flash memory, a crystal and a pair of capacitors. I advise you to take these components from an ESP-01 module. And practically, all you need to buy is a very cheap QFN32 breadboard adapter. I recommend you to measure and write down the resistances from the microcontroller chip's ground pad to its each individual little pad. If any two little neighbor pads should give exactly the same resistance, check that there is no solder bridge between them. Apply some flux and put the microcontroller to its new place. Use a hot air gun to solder firstly the ground pad. On the other side, solder a wire to the adapter plate's ground pad there. As a rule, not all the little pads get connected during the first hot air soldering. These problem pads tend to have a flat and dull appearance as in here. Apply a very small amount of inexpensive solder paste next to the dry joints that you have found. Heat gently so that the gray color of the solder paste evaporates away and the smelted liquid metal finds its way to the little pads. Repeat if necessary. Check that no two neighbor pads have accidentally gotten soldered together. Now check that the resistances from the ground wire to each individual pin are the same as those values that you measured earlier. If somewhere the resistances are not as earlier, you should suspect that in that area there is still a dry joint. If necessary, fix soldering problems and repeat previous steps. Solder some header pins to the adapter plate and solder the ground wire to the extra header pin that stands next to the pin number 17. Make the other end of the ground wire accessible to the upper side of the adapter plate. If we now put on a breadboard few wires, 6 resistors, 5 capacitors and a crystal, a blue LED, our brand new ESP do-it-yourself module and a flash memory, and switch the power on, we see the fundamental blink program working. Let's anyhow clean up this bunch of jumper wires. ESP8266EX Datasheet User Guide version 1.1 is one of the datasheets published by the manufacturer. On page 15, we see that for a flash memory connection, they use 8 wires that are a common ground and the wires that are connected to the microcontroller's pins from number 17 to number 23. As explained on page 15, there are good reasons to have a 200 ohm resistor placed between microcontroller pin number 21 and flash pin number 6. We also need a crystal oscillator. The oscillating circuit we construct and the values of its capacitors are shown on page 16. In the crystal, those two opposite corners that are electrically connected together are the ground pads. The other two corners are the crystal pads and we connect them to the pins number 27 and 28 of the microcontroller. Page 17 tells us that these wires should be short ones. Let's take a look at our breadboard. At this point, don't put yet anything to the antenna pin number 2 of the microcontroller. But otherwise, make all the connections that are drawn on page 12. As with ESP-01 module, if you want to run a program that is already written to a flash memory, you have to pull up the pins number 7, 14, 15 and 32 of the ESP-8266 chip. and according to the page 38, you have to pull down the pin number 13. These are all 12 kilo ohm resistors that I use here. In ESP-01 module, we have a LED and a resistor on the pin number 26. Let's put a LED and a similar 2.2 kilo ohm resistor here also. If we now power up the circuit, the microcontroller starts again running the very same blink program. Now, make a USB connection to your computer in the same manner as you would do it with an ESP-01 module. Solder a thin wire to the pad number 2 of our old ESP-01 module. Bend the original ground pin to the side and connect this practical antenna to your breadboard. According to the page 38, if one wants to upload a new program to a flash memory, the pin number 15 must be held low for a while. And while holding it low, the pin number 32 must be shortly connected to the ground. And finally, one is to release the pin number 15. Now start Arduino IDE, upload the example program Wi-Fi access point, and take a Wi-Fi connection from your smartphone to your new ESP do-it-yourself module.
Thank you for your attention. In the next video, we go a bit further, but anyhow, this is a very good start. Goodbye.